Is it the end of the trade war between the United States and China? Russia partially unblocks Ukrainian ports in the Sea of Azov. Alexander Yaroslavsky's DNP reduced the release of rolled products. Turkey has set steel export record. This and other metal market news in the weekly review of Metal News. The program is created with the technical support of the Tech Energoprom Group. Metals went up the reporting week because of the news of the truce in the United States-China trade war. Reducing tensions between the two countries improves the outlook for the metals market, experts said. The index of shares of mining companies calculated by Bloomberg jumped by 3.2% during the bidding due to a rise in stock prices of BHP plus 3.7%, Vale Indonesia Tbk Pt 9.9%, South 32 7.9% and others. United States President Donald Trump and Chinese President Xi Jinping, who met at their Great 20 summit in Buenos Aires, reached a number of agreements that were perceived by the market as a breakthrough in relations between the two countries. Washington will postpone the increase in duties on Chinese steel products and other goods. Beijing will increase imports from the States. The two countries have 90 days to resolve their differences. In accordance with the agreement reached by the heads of two states, the Chinese side will expand the volume of purchases of American goods, in particular agricultural products, in order to reduce the United States' deficit in trade with China, the White House said in a statement after the meeting. Zinc, which shows the worst dynamics this year among metal traded on the London Metal Exchange, LME, rose by 1.2%. The cost of copper in London rose by 1.7% to $6,303 per ton. Copper futures rose by 1.6% to $2,832 a pound. As of December 3, a movement of ships is recorded through the Kerch Strait in the direction of the Ukrainian ports in the Sea of Azov, according to the Minister of Infrastructure of Ukraine, Volodymyr Omelan. He stated that the ports of Verdansk and Mariupol are partially unblocked. Ships carry out their movement in the direction of the Ukrainian ports through the Kerch Strait. The ships are stopped by the Russian side, inspected as before, but the movement has been partially restored. According to him, 17 ships are awaiting putting to the Sea of Azov and one is waiting for the exit. Another 9 ships are docked in the ports. The head of the department noted that the unblocking of Ukrainian ports was made possible due to the coordinated activities of the Ukrainian authorities, tough and unequivocal international reaction, as well as the world media. Dnipropsky Metallurgical Plant, which was sold to DCH Structures by businessman Alexander Yaroslavsky in January-November 2018, reduced rolled steel production, according to the operational data, by 0.8% compared to the same period of 2017 years, up to 708,000 tons, writes Interfax Ukraine. During this period, the plant reduced steel production by 1.5% to 828,000 tons, pig iron by 15.4% to 800,000 tons. In November, the metallurgical plant produced 65,000 tons of rolled products, 72,000 tons of steel, 69,000 tons of pig iron, whereas in the previous month, 82,000 tons of rolled products, 90,000 tons of steel, 89,000 tons of iron. The company explained that the decline in production in June-July was due to a major overhaul with the modernization of the blast furnace number 3, which ended in early August. The second rail line was commissioned at the Evras WSMP Rail and Structural Workshop. The project will double the output of 100-meter P65 rails and produce European 60E1 and 54 E1 rails in lengths, which are in demand in foreign markets, 30, 36, 60, 72 and 90 meters. Investment in the project amounted to 168 million rubles. Technical re-equipment was carried out at the 100-meter-long rail section. Additional equipment was installed, the acceptance lines, strengthening and cutting lines were mounted. Due to the launch of the second line, the capacity of the rail and beam shop Evras WSMP will increase from 245,000 tons to 540,000 tons of 100-meter rails per year. According to the Turkish Steel Exporters Association (CIB), in November 2018, the national metallurgical companies, set a new absolute record, sending about 2.5 million tons of steel products to foreign markets, totaling $1.5 billion. In just 11 months of 2018, Turkish steel exports reached 19.3 million tons, which is 19.8% more than in January-November last year. Proceeds from external sales grew by 37.3% to about $14.1 billion. Turkey was forced to sharply increase its exports of steel products in the fall of the current year after the economic crisis in the country led to a sharp contraction in domestic demand. You are watching Metal News Review for the week. Indicative prices for the reporting week look like this. You have watched the weekly review of Metal News. Your subscription to the channel and clicking on the bell will allow you to be aware of the main events of the total metal market every week.